So, Mayor Kim, it's been 8 weeks. Today is the 8 week mark. Has any progress been made?
Not yet. Progress towards what?
A resolution in one way or another in the Kia'i, perhaps being more willing to compromise in some way?
I think some, I hate titles, but I'll just say protectors, okay? Because the opinions of protectors within themselves are very varied. I think you know that. And even some who put themselves in this group of being protectors are not even from here. And with that, some very limited knowledge on what this is all about. So in answering your question, the answer is, if you're talking about a core group, the answer is no. By progress, I mean willing to change openly at this time. The word compromise have to be a better word. I'll use a Hawaiian word to ho'oponopono, the issue, and see what we can resolve in a good way, and that's my goal. At this time, using your word of compromise, the answer is no, because their position has been, again, this core group. Don't even ask me how many and who is in it, because even that I'm not sure, because it's such a difficult thing because of the numbers and varied interests, positions. That some have said openly to you, the media, there will be no TMT, there will be no, in the future, no astronomy on Mauna Kea. And you can see how varied that is on just that position. So your answer is no.
So where do you go at this point? What can you do? I know you've been given the responsibility of being the mediator between the state and the Kia'i. That's
no.
Okay, explain to me, what is your role at this point?
It's in my mess here someplace in regards to what my role is. The governor asked me on this Sunday night, about 3 weeks ago or so. I should not have answered the phone that night. Anyway, I'm not kidding. He called to say if I would, I'm going to receive a letter on Monday, the following day, in regards to trying to come up with a proposal or some kind of presentation that would be acceptable, to the issue we have today. And with it, very little authority, as you can see, because he knew of what I have said publicly long time ago, I go before any assignment was given. And this time he made it formal. And my goal is to come up with a proposal of some kind that I think, and I'm stressing the word, I really believe that will be good for Hawaii and the world. Because that's what I said long time ago when I was asked, this is before I was mayor this time. And when I said this, when I was mayor the first time in the year 2000, with all the consultants that came here, my position on this, I want you to know, is not because of what's happening. I said this publicly for the first time in 1981, believe it or not, when the university asked me about Mauna Kea, and I told them about, people should know that for people of science, yes, but there are people that are not of science that looks upon this majestic mountain for some as part of their soul, just to elaborate and accentuate the differences of how this mountain is looked at. And like me, just a thing of beauty, of just a majestic, a mountain out there. Mm-hmm. And I just wanted people that was going to use it to be aware of it. And so with it, I said to proceed with care and caution, and above all, compassion, not realizing that this was going to be at that time such a controversial thing.
Mm-hmm. So the proposal that you are working on, what would that do? What is the end game of that proposal?
This is how sensitive it is. And I'm not going to ask you or your cameraman to say what you feel, but I think a lot of people feel it. You know, when people talk about the desecration of the mountain, naturally I have different opinions on that word desecration. I'm born and raised here, my goodness, 80 years ago, you weren't even a figment of anybody's imagination. And I remember the pain and the hurt of people that this was their home well before me and my father. And it goes back hundreds of years. I felt such a desecration of this beautiful place, and when I wrote that, I consider this the most beautiful place on God's earth, of not only a place, but of people. I saw what we did to the ocean. I have pictures here, somewhere in that folder there. That folder.
This one here. Okay.
In regards to, oh my goodness, it's a long one. Someplace in there is pictures of Hamakua coastline, of plantation desecration of the ocean. I'm working on projects now and trying to improve Hilo Bay. Take a look at this. This is a desecration of Pacific Ocean.
Yeah.
All the plantations along the east side of the island where the bulk of the plantations were, we did that. Mm-hmm. Look at this picture. This is a beautiful pond out there that finally we are changing. I'm so grateful for the changes we're making today. Mm-hmm. On Mauna Kea, and this is what I want to bring out, a proposal, but it's really not a proposal, it's a picture of some of the things. I think I'm willing to bet a lot of your viewers will not know, and hopefully when I finish this, it will be an accurate, trusting accuracy of what is and what was. I think a lot of people don't even know that of the major changes that have been made since the Legislative Auditor's Office came out with a criticism of Mauna Kea, and really was a real catalyst in the beginning of such a awareness. It was government that brought it out, the Legislative Auditor's Office, and it showed rightfully the mismanagement. It showed rightfully the quote-unquote disrespect of the development of the 12 scopes. Mm-hmm. We have only 13 scopes there. I shouldn't have said 13, but we have 13 because I'm taking out a thing that's been like a call of so many, no more. But we have not built a scope since 2002. 12 of the 13 telescopes was built before 2000. Remember, this report came out in, you know, the year 2000, mm-hmm. 1998, actually. Mm-hmm. So you can see, yes, there is no denial by people of the scope. I have a letter from them of commitment to go forward. That's what I hope to put in that brochure also. Mm-hmm. There's no denial by the University of Hawaii that we made bad mistakes in judgment. There's no denial by the governor, although he had nothing to do with any of it. Remember, he was our governor now for only, 6 years. No scope has been built since 2002, and again, 12 out of 13 was built before 2000. So all the criticism, I think, in the development of it was rightfully done. But we've got to put it in perspective at the time. Mm-hmm. I credit the government of Hawaii for being so much better than the vast majority of the 99% of the world that did such harm and wrong to the indigenous people of this world. Whether it be of the American Indians and the nations that they had, a beautiful, you know, nation of the Sioux and different people. Mm-hmm. Some of it resulted in brutal slaughter of the Indians and disregard of anything. I think of my time, which is just a speck of time in regards to the history of Hawaii, just a small speck. But within my time, I've told the governor this, I've told OHA this, and I've told Kamehameha schools this, and everybody that has no choice but to listen sometimes, how proud I am of how far we've gone. This past year, I went to 7 graduations. Every one of them come from college to the smallest in Kilkau with only 5 graduates, and mid-school, high school. Every one of them, a tremendous acknowledgement, respect to the Hawaiian culture. And you just sit there in awe. You sit there in appreciation. You sit there in sadness, because so many of my friends, especially of Hanai family, never saw this, because they obviously all passed away. Mm-hmm. Because most of these changes were brought out after, I think, 1980, slowly. Look at the Hawaiian language. I'm so proud of the state and all the University of Hawaii, who's going under heavy criticism. I think probably the whole world of treatment to indigenous people, maybe, only maybe, New Zealand can be comparable. The rest have a long ways to catch up to Hawaii. Look at our Hawaiian language programs of graduate school, public schools of Hawaiian language, immersion language schools. Mm-hmm. Look at from the time in the 1990s, okay, early 2000s, there was less, according to people who did this survey, there were less than 50 people of youth that could speak Hawaiian. Look at them now. Because of the commitment made, we have thousands.
There's so much progress.
And that's what I want to put forth. Mm-hmm. Do I excuse the anger? Of course not. I want us to understand anger so we can go forward even more. And there has to be ways we have to go forward. And that's what I want this proposal, you know, to bring out. That there is now a commitment to go forward where people never have made before outside beginning of the legislative auditor's report. And I hope to have some strong commitments on how we can go forward. And I truly believe this. I don't want Hawaii Island to be like the rest of the islands of Maui, Kauai, and Oahu that are known for a resort and function around that. I want us to be resolved and rotated around the culture of the Hawaiian people, along with that, the science of it. And I think we can do that.
So the proposal that you're working on is your way to, I guess, educate the greater public about the past as well as the present and Hawaiian culture and everything that it is, and try to find a way forward, correct?
That's correct.
Okay.
So I don't like the word educate, because it's people, you think I'm uneducated, you know, that's how sensitive we are sometimes, and we are there. The greatest sadness of where I am today is where we are, of polarization of people, of anger. And if you're on this side or that side, is overt anger being shown, and even fear of not saying what your position is because of fear of retaliation of the other group. Well, that's not the Hawaii I know. That's not the Hawaii I was so proud of, but I can understand the anger. So hopefully this will try to present something that will make us, you know, think about the whole picture a little bit and maybe understand our anger so we can kind of take it in better perspective. Okay. I'm going to read you one paragraph of this, probably be about 20 changes. The purpose of this presentation is beyond a yes or no of the TMT project. It is hoped that this proposal for the development of the TMT, along with astronomy, will set a new milestone for science and discovery. This is not only for new knowledge to the world, but will be a catalyst for positive transformational changes that truly embraces the harmony of culture and science. And that's my goal. And I really believe if we take the time to truly understand the whole picture, we can do this and not make a win or lose, because I don't care which side wins or which side loses. I'm afraid we're all going to lose.
Who will be, who will you be giving this proposal to?
You.
Media.
Media, the public, in any way or form. As I told Governor when he assigned this, I said, you do know I have a full-time job, a day job. It's taking me much longer because, I want everything to fit. I want everything to be presented. There's no right side or wrong side. Mm-hmm. This is just a proposal for you to think of that I, really believe it is a good thing for us as people of this place.
I've heard people say that they think that this should be put to a vote on what to do. Your thoughts on that?
That always comes up, not always, but comes up so many times on certain issues, and let the public vote. Some states have that, like Oregon, even on taxes of any kind of budget increase and this and that, and consider that truly. And in part that's true, but you know what I don't like about it many times, because I've been involved in things here on different issues, and some of it go to the public on a vote and a ballot. Unfortunately, so many times of that, it's like a political election. It's the campaign supporting this or that that wins. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately today, there's so much, people are so busy to be keep themselves informed, because there's so many issues, that people are not afraid to put out bad information to persuade their side. But that's always the case. So to come down to your question, should the public vote for it? I don't know if that will resolve what I wanted to resolve, because let's say the vote comes out 60-40, regardless of which side. It shows 40% don't favor it. And I would hate to have a community of this small size, and we are a small community. Let's just take this island, we're only 200,000 people. And to say, 80,000 don't want it, and 120,000 want it, it's still polarized. Mm-hmm. And that doesn't resolve the element of coming together. That's what I'm trying to do. Mm-hmm. So if you ask me personally, would I support dropping everything and say vote yes or no? No. Mm-hmm. I want us to come to a true coming together of what we want for this island.
After 8 weeks, there has been no real resolution, and we seem to be at a standstill. Your proposal, it seems, aims to try to share with everyone a goal of coming to an understanding so that we can move forward positively, that would make both sides happy. But
I didn't say that.
Well,
that's what I mean by picking
everyone. I'm summarizing,
word.
Yeah. You know what I mean?
No, the
I'm
word just happy.
Yeah, you're right. I don't think everybody's going to be happy with this, no matter which way it goes. But how can this move forward? It seems like there is no way that this will move forward without law enforcement removing, the protectors from Mauna Kea, because they've made it very clear that they don't intend to leave. I mean, just last week, the structure that they had erected up there, the unpermitted structure, was torn down just within days of it being put up. But that was a very swift action. It doesn't seem like there will be any, you know, resolution without some sort of law enforcement action.
I hope you're dead wrong. But there ain't no reality. It's a matter of, I think, what I consider moving forward. I think I've moved forward in some degree. When you say, oh, I told you about the core, certain core is no, it's a yes or no. But within the groups of people that have been willing to, you know, talk to each other, not to persuade, but to present a picture of where and how can we possibly go forward without this. And one thing, I'll take this opportunity. I really don't appreciate some of the media coverage. I remember it was just today or yesterday, I don't even remember days anymore. I read about the school in Maui. What is it, mid-school, the kids walked out of class or something because to show support of the desecration of the flag. Because of that, I'm gonna call the people of the enforcers and I want to triple check exactly what happened. Because I darn well know it wasn't as black and white as they went in there and tore it up off the wall and saw it in there. I know the planning within themselves, although I wasn't part of that planning, I know of the planning, the discussion that went within themselves of every step along the way, every step. Like the first time the decision was made, no force. Everybody sees the police or don't care or the sheriff department as people that have a badge and a gun. And that's really unfair. Most of them are people from this island or this state. A lot of them are torn between what they feel inside and what they are obligated to do by law. People don't emphasize the hardship of doing that. You think it was easy for them to do what they did? What the media showed is a kapuna being taken away. I use the word taken away. You never saw anybody being dragged away. Do we emphasize that? No. Well, what did it take to make sure that on that very emotional period that not one enforcement officer broke the rule of no force? Sure, on one side we have a lot of credit, which is credit is due of Aloha Kapuna, Kapu. Well, so did that practice by the enforcers. That's why decision was made that at a certain point we cannot continue this, because for every person we remove, they have someone waiting to take place. They didn't count on that kind of numbers. I got the call from the police chief saying of what they're doing is just not going to work and we have to resort to physicalness. He didn't say a baton and beat him to death, that kind of ugliness that you see all over the world. He's talking about we are just carrying them off one at a time, it's not going to work. And so the decision was made by the governor after whoever he consulted with. No physical force or force of pepper spray or taser gun to be used at this time. Stand down. Mm-hmm. I think I would have made the same decision. Heavy criticism by people. Why didn't you stand pat? Oh, yeah, right. Easy to Monday night quarterback everything. But try to be the one making that decision that enforces it. And what did you media do? And I'm really picking on you now. That's all you showed. Dramatic photos of kapunas laying down. But try to take a look next time closer at the eyes and tears of the enforcers. That's what I'm talking about, fairness in everything we do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, some of those guys did look very upset, I know. I know what you're talking about. As far as recent rumors, there's been many of them in the last 8 weeks about what's happening and what's potentially going to happen and, you know, what's coming down. National Guard. There have been rumors that National Guard is going to come in. But I believe that the governor needs to sign an emergency proclamation in order for that to happen.
Yeah, but the emergency proclamation, I do it all the time as mayor. Mm-hmm. When I see a hurricane approaching, the Corporation Council know, get a proclamation ready for Harry. Once we go on watch, not warning, mm-hmm. they bring it to me, I sign it. What he does is lay down the foundation of administrative work that needs to be done for me to do certain things in case it happens.
So is this something?
No, you know, the I got a call from this reporter. This is Monday, isn't it?
It's Monday.
I'm not kidding, I don't even know what day of the week it is. I think it was Saturday, I'm not even sure, who cares? But before today. Mm-hmm. Said, sorry to bother you at home, but, you know, there's a rumor and people are assembling because the guard's going to do this and that on Monday, meaning today. Mm-hmm. Well, what do I know about it? I said, wait a minute, what did you hear? Said, the National Guard is being assembled to start movement on things and the people are assembling on this rumor. And I said, well, I hope it's a nice trip because I don't think it's going to happen. I have heard nothing, you know, and the only thing I've heard from the governor is planning will always have to be intact in the event we have to. And that's all I know. I just talked to the governor this morning. I said, you know, the rumor is still going around. And he said, yeah, I know, but how else do you tell him? No, I have not called for. All we have is a basic plan that was there, what we got to do in the event. Mm-hmm. And we have no time frame of anything now. There's no even discussion now. And I promise you, and I promise your audience, he promised me that he would tell me. Mm-hmm. That we will be collaborative in regards to a major step like that, because we have to be. We all have to be on the same page in regards to what we're doing. This is that important. Mm-hmm. And he promised we will. And I promise you, there's nothing going on.
So it'll be another beautiful day on the Mauna.
Well, the rest of the world on the state anyway, especially Hilo or the Big Island. I don't know about your island. I'm only kidding. I'm making a lot of enemies.
Eric, anything? Any final?
So, in the last couple of weeks, few weeks, there's been, seems to be a little bit of an increase in terms of some of the law enforcement. They've been talking about changes to the parking structure. There's been some fines handed out. Friends have posted videos of roadblocks, checking every car. The structure was taken down. I guess I'm curious about the seemingly growing sense of security or of fines or whatnot, and also who's actually making those decisions. Is that something that is coming from your side of things, or is the governor directing that, given the fact that he had told you that he wanted you to perhaps do that? That's sort of a question that seems to be of a new in the last few weeks.
The answer is, but I answer the question in regards to the guards being called out.
Well, the
no,
traffic.
I'm going to answer it. From here on in, doesn't matter from when here means, from here on in, we agreed that we have to be together on whatever moves we make. In regards to specifically, I think this is all a plan that they had developed in regards to enforcement of certain things. I think I'm the one that raised the greatest complaint of the lack of enforcement on Sutter Road itself, Daniel K. Inouye Highway. Because that's the complaints we were getting a lot of, and I went up there and saw it. This is the only three arteries around the island, that's one of them. At this point, it's beginning to be the main artery of thousands of cars a day. And there was definitely traffic hold up, slow up, and everything else. And I wanted that to be under better control. So it was I that, you know, coordinated with the state highways and private security and the signal lights out there to get better control of that, because it was at that time being controlled by protectors. And that should not be. This is a government road. So that was done. I want that to be even more so in regards to personnel there. Within that, the state developed a plan in regards to traffic control. And that was what people are talking about, being increased of enforcing that, because it was getting to be a real problem of safety. And this is a thing that shows you the one-sidedness of things. I've said it 100 times, more or less. Our responsibility, the safety of the people. I'm not going to stop someone and say, are you crossing the street, are you for or against? Or driving. We've had near misses of cars, vehicles going to and fro, east and west, had nothing to do with it. Unfortunately for this, drivers around the world, especially the United States, drunken driving is almost part of every day. And go look at the near misses we had because of drunk driver. Go look at not drunk, but speeding or reckless driving. Where weekends you had literally thousands of people there initially, and weekdays hundreds. So the enforcement was made of controlling it. And all I read is like this is a clampdown on the protectors. I've said at the beginning, my job is not protectors. It's the protection of the people on this island. We had to gain control of that, which we were responsible for not doing initially. I don't think people anticipated this kind of, you know, numbers that would come up and what they would do as far as traffic problems. Monday night quarterbacking is the easiest job in the world. But some of it could have been predicted. And yes, we could have done a better job. But this is what it is of trying to do better. And signs along to prevent, especially in proximity to the access road of people, you know, in regards to cluttering that area up as far as parking alongside the streets. And that has been, a good job has been done on that by the state deciding to put up the signs and enforcing that. Because what good are the signs if you don't enforce it? Can I read something?
Sure.
I want everything in perspective, okay? I wrote this among the rest of this thing on a vision for Mauna Kea. This is about the recognition of a deeply painful history of intrusions on the First Nation of Hawaii, which today are reflected in issues such as Mauna Kea. It is about the wrongs done to indigenous people of the world whose scars remain fresh. If anything out of this interview, I need all of us who are not Hawaiians to understand what those words mean. I realize Hawaii has changed so much in the past 50 years and more and less of people. From what I understand, on a very general statement, almost 50% of the people of the state of Hawaii was not born here. And that's the way changes are. So I hear a lot about unfairness of what's going on. I want people to understand what I just read. There is no denying by anyone of knowledge, no one, that the pains that started in the takeover of the monarchy of the place called Hawaii was an illegal venture. What we have to understand is, yes, it was there. We also have to understand, but that is our past. And within the present structure of government, and I like being part of the United States rather than other places, we have made a lot of great changes that the world envies in regard to the indigenous people of Hawaii, the First Nation of Hawaii. We got to recognize, but before that, look at the pain. That although it was not shown in so many different ways, and that's why I wrote this. In recent weeks, Mauna Kea has added to the remarkable Hawaiian cultural renaissance, the Hawaiian identity, and the pride of being Hawaiian. Along with that, the reverence and sacredness for the total environment. My goodness, if we could all just back up to understand that. And on the Hawaiian side, understand that there are many who are doing everything they can to make it better. All I am asking is for both sides to understand it and work together to go forward.
I know that Governor Ige has been criticized for not taking swifter action, for not resolving this. I believe you've come under fire as well in that same vein for not taking swifter action. Your thoughts on that?
Like I tell people, if I could Monday night quarterback everything, I'd be a billionaire today. All I have to do is bet every Monday night football game, the day before the game. And that's being facetious, where this is not a time for that. I was not involved in the initial planning of this, of reaction, but I was aware of it as we went along. First of all, I don't think, you know, any decision. Can you imagine? Just imagine what would have happened. And I don't know what would have happened, but if force was used that first day. Kapu aloha is a beautiful word of conduct in what they did compared to, let's just take Hong Kong. Let's just take anywhere. But I say Hong Kong because that's been so visual. A lot of times I watch the news and I don't even know where that country is that having a demonstration, and I see people with batons and kicking. I am so proud of us, and I mean it, I am so proud of us, of the protective side, the royal order of Kamehameha people, of making sure these things, you know, followed and what it means. Of standing out there in the hot sun in their coat and tie. I suffer with Bermuda shorts and a lower shirt to make sure everybody followed that. They made that, that's what they will do. On the enforcement side, they did the same. And that's why that day was called, we cannot do what we want to do of control unless force is given. Use. Even on Monday night quarterback, and I would say, I said it, I would have done the same thing the governor did. I don't have the heart to say, use pepper spray or drag them off out of there. They could have done that. Where we are today is because of decision made that let's try to resolve this in a good way. That's why this assignment is given to me. We'd have to accept all the criticism of what we should have or could have done. And I'll put that away for now. Because what good is it going to do except if you want to throw stones, they're throwing it. I feel very sympathetic towards the governor, towards the president of the University of Hawaii. Both of them are taking a lot of criticism. Some of them may be, you know, justified. But some of them I think not. I will continue to do this with the hope and a vision that we can get together to resolve this in a good way. Not a right way, okay? In a good way. I do believe in astronomy, the field science of astronomy, along with the TMT, the most advanced telescope of the world to be placed on this little place called Hawaii Island to give us something to work around besides just tourism. I do believe mistakes were made by the university and the telescope people below the year 2000 when most all the scopes were built. I do believe of the major changes were made because started with the legislative audit report and the change of the plans of mandating now of no more scopes beyond the total 13. I believe in the identification of scopes that will be decommissioned and removed. And these scopes, two of them at least, will be removed before TMT is up. I do believe in the rules of conduct of no explosives and those things that was done before. All known mistakes we should not have made. I'll identify what I'm going to try to make comment. Why I believe this can be done in a good way. And you know what I get excited about? I really mean excitement. To think that this little island can be the center of the universe study of astronomy for the world. To know that the best scientists of the world are five different countries and the academians behind them willing to spend $1 billion to develop this scope. To know that the university and know that the plan that was accepted in the year 2005 changes everything of the past development and the carelessness and the disrespect can be done to make Hawaii State the center of astronomy of the world in a good way.